But surely you can question my policies without questioning my faith. Or for that matter, my citizenship. Challenging each other's ideas can renew our democracy, but when we challenge each other's motives, it becomes harder to see what we hold in common. We forget that we share, at some deep level, the same dreams, even when we don't share the same plans on how to fulfill them. We may disagree about the best way to reform our healthcare system, but surely we can agree that no one ought to go broke when they get sick in the richest nation on earth. We can take different approaches to ending inequality, but surely we can agree on the need to lift our children out of ignorance, to lift our neighbors from poverty. We may disagree about gay marriage, but surely we can agree that it is unconscionable to target gays and lesbians for who they are, whether it's here in the United States or, as Hillary mentioned, more extremely in odious laws that are being proposed most recently in Uganda. Surely we can agree to find common ground when possible, parting ways when necessary, but in doing so, let us be guided by our faith and by prayer. For while prayer can buck us up when we are down, keep us calm in a storm, while prayer can stiffen our spines to surmount an obstacle, and I assure you, I'm praying a lot these days. Prayer can also do something else. It can touch our hearts with humility. It can fill us with a spirit of brotherhood. It can remind us that each of us are children of an awesome and loving God. Through faith, but not through faith alone, we can unite people to serve the common good. And that's why my Office of Faith-Based and Neighborhood Partnerships has been working so hard since I announced it here last year. We slashed red tape and built effective partnerships on a range of uses, from promoting fatherhood here at home to spearheading interfaith cooperation abroad. And through that office, we've turned the Faith-Based Initiative around to find common ground among people of all beliefs, allowing them to make an impact in a way that's civil and respectful of difference and focused on what matters most. It is this spirit of civility that we are called to take up when we leave here today. That's what I'm praying for. I know in difficult times like these, when people are frustrated, when pundits start shouting and politicians start calling each other's names, it can seem like a return to civility is not possible, like the very idea is a relic of some bygone era. The word itself seems quaint. Civility. But let us remember those who came before, those who believed in the brotherhood of man even when such a faith was tested. Remember Dr. Martin Luther King. Not long after an explosion ripped through his front porch, his wife and infant daughter inside, he rose to that pulpit in Montgomery and said, "Love is the only force capable of transforming an enemy into a friend." In the eyes of those who denied his humanity, he saw the face of God. Remember Abraham Lincoln, on the eve of the Civil War, with states seceding and forces gathering, with a nation divided, half slave and half free, he rose to deliver his first inaugural and said, "We are not enemies, but friends. Though passion may have strained, it must not break our bonds of affection." Even in the eyes of Confederate soldiers, he saw the face of God. Remember William Wilberforce, whose Christian faith led him to seek slavery's abolition in Britain. He was vilified, derided, attacked. But he called for lessening prejudices and conciliating goodwill, and thereby making way for the less obstructed progress of truth. In the eyes of those who sought to silence a nation's conscience, he saw the face of God. Yes, there are crimes of conscience that call us to action. Yes, there are causes that move our hearts and offenses that steer our souls. But progress doesn't come when we demonize opponents. It's not born in righteous spite. Progress comes when we open our hearts, when we extend our hands, when we recognize our common humanity. Progress comes when we look into the eyes of another and see the face of God. That we might do so, that we will do so, all the time, not just some of the time, is my fervent prayer for our nation and the world. Thank you. God bless you, and God bless the United States of America.